Formula V Association of Queensland are back for their final race of the weekend, and it's been the all Paul show this weekend. More specifically, Paul Monteith has had three wins from three starts. Paul Kellaway has been able to claim 3 second places. This confrontation between Paul Monteith in the Volt Engineering Rapier and Paul Kellaway in the Mick Motors Jacer.
And we've had some great battles between the two of them in all three of the races that we've had so far. So it'll be interesting here, Mark Jones, to see if this damp track surface changes the running order. Paul Monteith's won all three races, but only just. We've had some unbelievably tight margins. I think if you were to add up the finishing margin in all three races, it would be less than half a second in total that separated those two cars at the finish line.
And Paul Monteith has been on the Facebooks today, tweeting away in with glee, "I'm back."
You said that he's been on the Facebooks tweeting away.
Well, I'm mixing my metaphors ever so slightly there. But yeah, he has been rather enthusiastically sharing the joy.
Let's just say brand that he's been race. Self-promoting via his social media channels.
Brand new engine aboard the Volks Engineering Rapier, and it's been running a peach this weekend. Eddie McFall there, starting out of position number three, also displaying a new race engine today in his BC, and he has been best of the rest of everyone not named Paul.
Away we go. Final race, 7 laps the distance for this one, and a great start from the outside of the front row this time for Paul Kellaway. So he will jump to the lead. Monteith slots into second. It'll be Scott Andrew in the red car there who moves up ahead of Eddie McFall into third position. And I have a feeling that there would have been a bit more grip on the outside of the circuit there, because that's the section of the circuit that will start to dry out on the racing line.
Those nice fat Formula 3 wet weather tyres would have redistributed the water on the racing line there quite effectively, I would think. Although they don't, when they come over the crest here at Morgan Park, they start wide on the right-hand side of the circuit and then drift across to the left, going down the front straight. So it's not like they're going on a consistent line down the front straight. So there's not really a favoured line, as we see. Kellaway has been able to get away from Monteith to the tune of about, you'd say it was 2 car lengths in both classes, but these are Formula Vs, and a little on the small side, and that's probably 3 Formula V car lengths as they tip down the hill. Scott Andrew has made a sensational start, and he's just built on it. He's well clear of Eddie McFall and David Hederman.
And Hederman actually up behind McFall quite closely in this race, so he
did get a good start.
Once again, Alan Don running at the back of the field with the old model 1200cc Formula V.
The Stag that Alan Don's racing here this weekend is a registered Group V historic racing car. Up over the crest, the Pauls go. Kellaway is actually going away from Monteith here. You can see in a straight line, it's Monteith's definitely far enough behind that he can't slipstream the Jacer.
Just a bit of sunlight creeping through the clouds as well, so that will probably help the circuit dry out to some extent.
Yeah, that's the first belt of sunshine we've seen in a couple hours here. And gratefully received by all. We may be in Queensland, but we're a couple hours away from the coast. It gets reasonably chilly here of an evening.
Still quite damp down there at turn 4. You can see some of the drivers running slightly wider lines there, looking for a bit of extra grip.
Yeah, they're taking very delicate lines through Gumtree Corner just there. And Kellaway and Monteith, first and second. Now, this is the furthest apart these two have been all weekend.
It has. Monteith just hasn't quite had the pace to run with Kellaway in these damp conditions. We've got a three-way battle starting to emerge for the third, fourth, and fifth Hedeman are both catching up to Scott Andrew.
The Formula V control tyre is a treaded tyre. Isn't a lot of tread to be fair. The front tyres, it's just a couple of grooves that run up the centre of the tyre. It's a treaded tyre nonetheless, so the grip is a bit of a premium out there. Once they got their third race this morning in before any rain fell on the circuit. So this is all new territory for the Formula V's this weekend. So David Hedeman there in the older Jabiru is doing a great job of hanging on to Scott Andrews' Rapier and Eddie McFall's BC. Technically speaking, Eddie McFall's car is actually older than David Hedeman's, but it has been upgraded many times. McFall's car, and of course, as mentioned earlier, they're sporting a brand new engine today. It's unfortunate to lose Alex Hedeman out of the program so early on. His chaser would have been a fine contributor to the battles going on. Might not have been able to hang on to the all-Paul show.
As David Hedeman riding on the tail of Eddie McFall.
He's reveling in this wet weather in these damp conditions.
That section of the track there is just about dry now, but as they head down the bottom of the hill into turn 9, the turn starts to get quite damp and you start to see spray being kicked up once again, particularly if you go off the racing line, as David Hedeman did there.
There's not a lot of sun down there in the region of the turns. 8 really through to 12. The gum trees aren't close to the circuit there, but they are tall, and it's with the sun quite late in the day now. There's corners down at that end of the circuit are not getting any sun, unlike turns 1, 2 and 3 here, as we can see Kellaway and Monti.
And Paul Manteat set the fastest lap of the race at a 1 minute 43.3, so he did close in on Kellaway. 1.1 seconds the margin between the two cars with four laps remaining. And I reckon that as the circuit becomes less wet, Manteat might just buy his way into this equation, and we could be set once again for another pretty exciting finish right at the end, which would be cool if we could have four races all decided by less than a second. That'd be a great advertisement for the close competition that we do have in Formula V racing.
Indeed. And I tell you what, Paul Kellaway's got to be absolutely enjoying this right at the moment, having the gap here on Paul Monteat. It's not a lot of a gap. Monteat's been out of racing for a couple of years now, and when Monteat was racing, Kellaway couldn't beat him unless circumstances intervened. So to be able to lead Monteat around, finally defeat Paul Monteat on his return to circuit racing, Kellaway will enjoy that tremendously.
Kellaway, the reigning Queensland Formula V champion, of course. And this round not actually worth any points in terms of the Queensland Formula V championship, but still an opportunity for the drivers to demonstrate their talents at a national level event. And once again, Paul Manteat quicker than Paul Kellaway by 3/10 of a second. So the margin down to 8/10 of a second with 3 laps remaining.
We're actually not far away from the next round of the championship, which will be here. As we look at the Stag of Alan Don, historic Formula V, a 1970s car, this one. Car that's familiar to many. It's been racing here in Queensland for a number of years. Has always been a Formula V championship in Queensland. It's been a number of competitors and long-running journalist in the Warwick region for the Warwick Daily Times is Cole Furness. We lost Cole well over a decade ago. and he was a prominent Formula V racer in his day, and his Nimbus historic Group V car still races in this part of the world, and his son Jamie is a prominent HQ racer these days. As the two Pauls trying to go side by side, Monteith was looking a little racy on the exit out of the T-junction there.
Steve Norbaugh, another journalist who also raced in Formula V for a number of years.
And Bruce Moxon.
Yep.
And his father as well.
Indeed. So Steve Norbaugh, of course, editor of the Chevron Motorsport publications. And he thoroughly enjoyed racing in this category. As we come down to two laps to go, let's have a look at what the margin is this time through. Down to 1:44.1 for both drivers, so the margin remains at 0.7 of a second. And the other interesting thing is that Eddie McFall's up to third and David Hedeman's up to fourth. So Scott Andrew has had an issue and fallen back into the fifth position.
And 3 seconds behind David Hedeman as well. So that would tend to suggest that maybe Scott Andrew's been off the track somewhere. He had a rather large off in the race this morning and he never got that ground back again. It's a shame for Scott because he's shown good pace here this afternoon. Paul Calloway there leading. Paul Monteith, the Fusion Financial Group, Rapier. ...2009 build, that particular car. Every bit as good as this Jacer he's chasing there, which is a similar age, actually. Paul Calloway's car, I think, is a 2007 model. Our race leaders closing in on 1200cc racer, Alan Don.
It's closed in once again, hasn't it? I still think Calloway just seems to come onto the main straight a little bit more strongly than Paul Monteith, and that was what we saw in the previous race as well. Out of the last corner they come, and this will be to start the final lap for the weekend. Monteith right in the slipstream of Calloway, and he'll look to the outside as they head across the line.
Oh, this one's going to go all the way to the end.
Again. So another Formula V race that'll come right down to the wire.
Well, we see it
turns in a bit earlier there. Calloway just clipping the exit strip. Turn number two.
Yeah, Monteith had two goes at getting the car around the corner just then, so it's lost him some space. Under brakes into Gumtree Corner. Both drivers, very smooth run through the corner, taking a conservative line. They're not touching the apex. They're not within half a car width of the apex. Well, Calloway was a fair bit wider at Siberia that time, so Monteith's gained some ground, maybe half a car length, into T-junction, and again, Calloway was wider. And I think Monteith didn't carry as much speed through the T-junction just then.
Yesterday we saw some great moves down through this part of the circuit into turn number 9.
Yeah, they were frequently side by side, weren't they, on the run down the hill?
The also, the battles. Yeah, the difficulty today is because it's still very wet off the racing line, it makes it harder to run side by side. So Calloway might have just done enough here. We've got two corners left to go.
Well, turns 11 and 12 are still treacherous, of course, so anything can yet happen. But I think now Calloway can maybe feel a little bit relaxed. He'll be trying to force his foot through the bulkhead.
Checkered flag comes out and it's 0.18 of a second. So again, we get a race decided by well and truly under a second in the Queensland Formula V series.
And Paul Calloway will savour that victory over a long-time rival. And in treacherous conditions too, to make it all the sweeter. As we see David Hedeman coming to the line here. He's lapped Alan Donlay in the running, but Hedeman has claimed a surprise third place there. He's kept the Jabiroo straight and true over the course of this wet race. And Eddie McFall and Scott Andrew have made missteps, and it's rewarded Hedeman with third place in the final race of the day.
Which is his best finish of the weekend, so very well done to David Hedeman there, getting his best result of the weekend. And Alan Don obviously winning the 1200cc / historic class there, finishing up in that sixth position outright.
Yeah, all six cars made the finish in the end. And you can see from the gaps there just how big a gap the two Pauls in first and second place had over David Hedeman. 22 and a half seconds at the end of the race. Certainly they had them covered in the wet conditions.